Good morning, guys. In today's lecture, we will going on the next part from the design of belt conveyor system for material handling. Okay, last lecture we have seen how to work that flat belt conveyor. There are different parts and the function of that parts we have covered in the last lecture. Means what is the use of head pulley, drive pulley, it is also called as a drive pulley. Then tail pulley, snub pulley, belt carrying idler, then return idler, or it is also called as a rollers. Then what is the use of bend pulley? What is the use of take up tension device? Then there are different cleaners are used. Belt cleaner internal as well as external cleaners are used, or it is also called as a scraper. Then what is the use of conveyor belt? Then what is the use of feeder, what is the function of hopper, all these things we have seen in the flat belt conveyor. In today's lecture, we will cover the remaining part from the unit number 3, means method of feeding, or we can say the loading to the flat belt conveyor. There are different methods are used for the loading to the flat belt conveyor, or we can say the feeding. I will share the my screen and explain with the help of PPT. First, see there are 4 methods is used for the feeding or loading to the flat belt conveyor. First is a by hopper method. Second is a by preceding conveyor. Third is a by process equipment, and last is a by traveling machine. That 4 methods are used for the feeding to the flat belt conveyor. We'll see one by one. Then see the first is a by hopper method. Okay, what is the use of hopper? We are load the material in the hopper, and through that feeder, this material is coming on the flat belt conveyor. Right, the feeder is extract the material from the hopper. Right, this feeder is the extract the material from the hopper, and they are control rate and feeds it into the conveyor. Okay, means we have feed the material in the hopper. Okay, and that material is coming down from the hopper to the feeder, and this feeder are extract that material from the hopper, and that control rate and feeds it to the conveyor. This shown in figure. Here is a hopper and feeder. This is the first method. Means you can feeding the material through hopper. Okay. All of you getting? Yes, very simple method is given. You should remember with the help of figure. Here is a hopper is given. Below that feeder is given. And this feeder is feed the material to the flat belt conveyor. Okay. The next method, we'll see the next method by preceding conveyor. See, preceding conveyor, we are using the 2 different conveyor. See, there is one is the discharging conveyor and another is a receiving conveyor. Okay, receiving conveyor and discharging conveyor. Okay, as per the application, we'll use that by preceding conveyor. See, there is a discharge of the preceding conveyor is taken as the feed for the next conveyor. Feed for the next conveyor. And so here is a discharging unit. Here is a receiving conveyor unit. Okay, all of you getting? The discharge of preceding conveyor is taken as the feed of the next conveyor. Next conveyor means we want to the, there are 2 different conveyor. Okay, then we are using the preceding conveyor. One is the discharging conveyor and another is a receiving conveyor. In that condition, we are using the preceding conveyor. Okay, then next one, by process equipment. Okay, by process equipment, here is a, see that process equipment, discharge from the process equipment. Here is a, again, hopper is shown. Okay. In the process equipment, see, this discharge from the process equipment, for example, or like crusher is there, mixer is there, screen is there, etc. is taken from the feed for the conveyor. Feed from the conveyor. Okay, that's shown in the figure by the process equipment. Okay, there are we are using the different equipment. I have given the example. You can use the hopper as the process equipment. You can use the crusher is the process equipment, or mixer is there. Okay, we can use the different feed by the process equipment. Remember that. Okay, then next is a traveling hopper. Next is a traveling hopper is there. This traveling machine, like we can use the traveling hopper. Okay, I have shown in this figure. Last type is a, there is a one traveling hopper are shown that feed the material to the conveyor. Feed the material is conveyor. Means before that, in the first by hopper, we have seen that hopper is stationary. Okay, that hopper is stationary. But in the last traveling hopper, here is a hopper is moving. Hopper is moving through that belt. Okay, a traveling hopper that feed the material to the conveyor. The feeding point of the conveyor in this case, check that traveling hopper. This feeding point of the conveyor will shift according to the position of the traveling machine. Means when this hopper is moving, then the feeding point of the conveyor will shift according to the position of the traveling machine. Okay, sometimes here, sometimes here, sometimes here, you will get that traveling hopper. And we'll do the feeding point on the conveyor, we'll shift the according the position of the traveling machine. There are these four methods are given for feeding to the material on the flat belt conveyor, or we can say the loading the material to the flat belt conveyor. All of you getting? This is very simple, by hopper, then by preceding conveyor, by process equipment, and by traveling machine. You have to remember with the help of example. By hopper, there is a hopper is stationary. Second is a preceding conveyor. Preceding conveyor, we are using the, there are two conveyor. One is the receiving conveyor, another is a discharging conveyor. The third is a process equipment. In the process equipment, like there is a hopper, crusher is there, mixture is there, etc. Okay. Is taken the feed from the conveyor. Remember that in process equipment. And last is a traveling hopper. In this case, this traveling hopper feed the material to the conveyor. The feeding point of the conveyor will shift according to the position of the traveling machine. Okay. Then next, there is again, see, there are next point is the method of discharge, or we can say the unloading from the flat belt conveyor. Flat belt conveyor. Again, there are four methods of discharge from the belt conveyor. Okay, from the flat belt conveyor, or unloading from the flat belt conveyor. First is a head pulley discharge. Second is a both end discharge. Third is a tripper discharge. This tripper discharge again divided into the two types, fixed tripper discharge and traveling tripper discharge. We'll see the details. And plow discharge, we'll see one by one. This again method discharge from the flat belt conveyor. These four methods are given. First is a head pulley discharge. Head pulley discharge. We have seen this, what is the function of the hopper and what is the function of the feeder, what is the function of the head pulley, already we have seen in the last lecture. Head pulley discharge means name itself explain the head pulley discharge. See, in this method the material flows from the feeder point, okay, feeder point to the head pulley. Check that we are loading the material in hopper, and this material is coming through that feeder on the flat belt conveyor. This flat belt is rotating, okay, through that head pulley. Okay, then we will get this discharge point is the nearest to the head pulley. Means this material flow from the feeder point to the head pulley along with the belt and the discharge from the belt at the head pulley. Okay. This is the most widely used and natural method for material discharge from the belt. Okay. Maximum times, and this is the natural, the method is used for the material discharge from the belt. Okay, all of you getting? Very simple. You have to remember that this material flow from the feeder point to the head pulley along with the belt, and the discharge from the belt at the head pulley. Here is a discharge point. Okay. Second method is a both end discharge. Okay. We have seen in the head pulley discharge there is a only one end of the discharge, but sometimes we require the both end discharge. Means here is a, there are two conditions. When the hooper, check that, when the belt is moving in the forward direction or towards the head pulley, then there we'll get the one discharge. And when the belt is moving in reverse direction, then we will get the discharge at the end pulley. Okay, means the reversible conveyors are used. Okay, there are a reversible conveyor are used for the discharge at the both ends. Okay, here we are using the reversible conveyor. Okay, what is mean by reversible conveyor? If you have check at the head end while running in forward direction, okay, and alternatively at the tail end while running in the reverse direction, we'll get the discharge from the flat belt conveyor. Okay, all of you getting? Okay, as per application, we want to the choose the method of discharge for the flat belt conveyor. Okay, here we require the both end discharge. That's why we are using the reversible conveyor. Okay, at the head end while running in the forward direction. Okay, and alternatively at the tail end while running in the reverse direction, there we'll get the both end discharge. Then next is a fixed tripper discharge. This is the type of the tripper discharge. Before going on the fixed tripper discharge or traveling tripper discharge, you know what is mean by tripper discharge. Okay, this tripper discharge arrangement is made by the forming the belt loop. Okay, belt loop in a upper run of the belt by means of a tripper pulley. Okay, in the fixed tripper discharge, see here is a, I have shown one figure. See this, in this figure there are a tripper pulley are shown. Okay, the arrangement is made by forming the belt loop in upper run of the belt by means of a tripper pulley shown in the figure. This method is used to dividing the discharge. Okay, when we want to the divide the discharge into different way, then we are using the tripper discharge. The intermediate discharge of required quantity can be obtained from the tripper pulley. Okay, again, see, intermediate discharge can be obtained from the tripper pulley. Okay, as per your required quantity. How much quantity is required? As per that, you can use the intermediate discharge. At that time, again, we are using the tripper discharge. This tripper discharge can be one or both side of the conveyor belt. Okay. This is the one side or both side of the conveyor belt. Okay, we'll see how it possible. First, see the, there are a types of the tripper discharge arrangement are shown. In the first type, fixed tripper discharge. Second is a traveling tripper discharge. Fixed mean, in fixed tripper discharge arrangement, the location of the tripper is fixed. This tripper location are fixed. Okay, here we'll get the one discharge, and here we'll, at the dry pulley, we'll get the another discharge. Okay, this fixed discharge, the location of this discharge is fixed. Tripper is fixed. Location of the tripper is fixed. At the intermediate section, shown the fixed tripper discharge. Okay. Remember that here is some arrangement are shown. This drive or head pulley are shown. Then tripper pulley are shown. Feeder is there. Hooper is there. When you feed the material through that hooper, then these are coming in the feeder. Feeder to belt conveyor. This material is traveling towards the head pulley. Then there are we are using the tripper pulley. Okay, and there is again we have making one discharge point. This discharge point is called as a tripper discharge. Means the location of the tripper is fixed in the fixed tripper discharge. Second is a traveling tripper discharge. As shown, see the figure. In traveling discharge, there is making some arrangement. The tripper arrangement reciprocate along the belt length between two limits. Belt length. Between two limits means the tripper arrangement that reciprocate along the belt length between two limits. Okay, we are consider that tripper along the belt length. We have considered there are two limits. Here is a first limit and here is a second limit. In that in between that two limit, we required the discharge. We required the discharge. That's why we have fixed there is a two tripper points. Two tripper points. This tripper level. Okay, we have fixed that tripper level and here we'll get the discharge. Okay, all of you getting? Then next point is a plot discharge. Plot discharge. What is the plot discharge? This plot discharge is used for the intermediate discharge. This plot discharge is used for the intermediate discharge when we require the small quantity in case of slow feed, okay, flat belt conveyor, okay, in case of when we require the slow speed of the flat belt conveyor, this shown in the figure, okay, this plow diverts the material to plow fall from one side of the belt. One side of the belt. Okay. The plow can be positioned as per the requirement of the discharge point. Okay. Sometimes as per requirement here, sometimes here, sometimes here. You can change the position of that discharge plow. Okay. You will get the only one side of the flow of that material is fall. Okay. This is the one of the biggest disadvantages of the plow discharge. Is it leads to the faster wear of the belt. Faster wear of the belt. Okay. This is the one of the biggest disadvantage of the plow discharge. Plow discharge. Okay. All of you getting this? Then next thing is we'll see the types of the belt. We have covered the flat belt conveyor. Okay. Then what is the second type of the belt? This is the trip belt conveyor. Okay, we have seen the flat belt conveyor. Then we'll see the next type is a trip belt conveyor. We'll see the details. This is the types of the conveyor. Flat belt conveyor we have completed in the last lecture. Then today's lecture we'll see the trip belt conveyor. Trip belt conveyor. Okay, what is the trip belt conveyor? We'll see that details, trip belt conveyor. Okay, trip belt conveyor when we use, if you have given the trip or we can say the shape to the belt by means of the idler, okay. The volume carrying capacity of that conveyor can be increased with the help of that idler. Such conveyor are known as a trip belt conveyor, means the volume carrying capacity of the conveyor can be increased by the idler. Okay, such type of the conveyor is called as a trip belt conveyor. See in the figure, here is a flat belt conveyor. In the trip belt conveyor, generally there are a three idler tub belt, or we can say the five idler type is there. Three idler type or five idler type is there. Okay, this is the cross section of the flat belt and tub belt conveyor shown is there. Okay, when you required the carrying capacity is maximum, then we are using the tub belt conveyor. Okay, with increase the number of idlers, the depth of the tub again increases. You see, here we are using the three idler, and here we are using the five idler. Okay, if you are using the five idler, then again you will get the maximum depth as compared to the three idler. Okay, then that higher the depth, higher is the required the flexibility of the belt. Okay, if you are using the maximum idler, then required the more flexibility of the belt. The we are using the material of the belt is nylon and polyester belt. Okay, there are two materials are used for the flat belt conveyor, nylon and polyester. Okay, which are more flexible than the cotton belts. Okay, if you are using the cotton belts, they are less flexible as compared to the nylon and polyester material are used for the tub belt conveyor. Remember that, nylon and polyester. Okay, when you required the maximum volume capacity, then we are using the tub belt conveyor. Okay, there are two, generally we are using the three idler type or five idler tub belt. Also, we have seen in the sugar factory industry at the time of the visit that tub belt conveyor. Okay, when the sugar is passed, okay, then we required the maximum volume at the end of the manufacturing of the sugar unit. There we are using the idlers. Okay, we are using the idlers. Okay, then what is the advantages of the tub belt conveyor? First is the volume carrying capacity of that tub belt conveyor is higher than as compared to the flat belt conveyor. This is due to the what? Tub shape. Okay, tub shape of that belt. See, this is the tub shape of the belt. Okay, this tub belt conveyor can be operated at the higher speed as compared to the flat belt conveyor, because when you increase the speed of the flat belt conveyor, then we'll get we'll lose the balance. But in the tub belt conveyor, we can't lose the balance because we have given the proper they are getting the proper support of the material through that tub shape. Okay, this is the one of the advantage of the tub belt conveyor. Again, this tub belt conveyor are more convenient for handling. There are different types of the material, okay, bulk as well as the loose material as compared to the flat belt conveyor. Okay, we are using loose material on that flat belt conveyor, then they are sometimes will be dropped from the flat belt conveyor. But here is a tub shape is given. That's why that material is getting the more support as compared to the flat belt conveyor. That's why we are using the bulk as well as the loose material. Okay, then they are not dropped through that tub shape. Okay, this is the one of the advantage of the tub belt conveyor. Then what is the disadvantages or limitation of the tub belt conveyor? See, if you have checked the ground clearance, or we can say the tub belt conveyor cannot adopt the natural contours of the ground. Contours of the ground. If you have increased, then again there is a problem. They are not adopt the natural contours of the ground. This is the one of the disadvantage. Second, tub belt conveyor cannot be operated over the long distance. Over the long distance, we are using for the small distance because we don't get the ground clearance okay, as per the requirement. If you are using the for the long distance, they are touched to the ground because of material wet. Okay, that's why we are operated for the small distance only. Okay, this is the one of the disadvantages. Okay, the trip belt conveyor requires again the high power for their operation. Okay, as compared to the flat belt conveyor. Okay, trip belt conveyor required the more power, or we can say the high power for the operation. Then what about the cost? Again, if you have compared with the flat belt conveyor, then trip belt conveyor cost is a very high, because if you have seen the weight of the conveyor as compared to the flat belt conveyor, the weight of the conveyor is more than the flat belt conveyor. This trip belt conveyor weight is a more than the flat belt conveyor. This is the heavy belt. Okay, again, this if you think about the construction, then construction is more complicated, okay, as compared to the flat belt conveyor. Okay, and the initial cost is very high as compared to the flat belt conveyor. This is the one of the disadvantage. Okay, then what about the maintenance cost of the trip belt conveyor? Then again, this maintenance cost is a maximum as compared to the flat belt conveyor. Okay, all of you getting what is the trip belt conveyor? When we use the trip belt conveyor, what is the application, advantages and disadvantages of the trip belt conveyor? Okay, all of you getting? Yes, trip belt conveyor. In today's lecture, we'll stop here. Next lecture, we'll see the capacity of the belt conveyor. Capacity of the belt conveyor. How to calculate the capacity of the belt conveyor. Thank you.